Like, I can wrap my head around taking a Figma design and then having to manually drag and drop things into Editor X without code. That makes sense to me. But now you're telling me that I can automatically turn my Figma design into an Editor X site without even dragging and dropping? I can't even. What? Hey friends, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey and I'm a web designer. What's going on here? Why do we see all of the stuff? The mess, the notebooks, the loose earbuds, not even the cool ones. Disaster. It's actually always like this, but what you normally see is much more tight and well curated. You see something more like this. Now that's more like it. The reason why I'm doing this is because the software I'm going to show you here, it's in beta at the time of this recording, which means not everything's perfect. You're going to get a little snapshot of what's going on, but what's really happening, there's a lot happening. So we might come across some bugs, and by no means is it perfect. Kind of like the way I make stuff. Do my best to give you a snapshot, but what's outside of the frame? Bah, we don't know. Anyway, I don't know if that was a terrible segue into this video, but what we're gonna do is we're gonna try this plugin out and we're gonna see if we can convert our Figma design into Editor X with as little friction as possible. Let's see what happens. All right, so I got this Figma file here that I designed a little while back. I just made a bunch of different designs just for fun, like landing pages, the same landing page designed in a few different ways. You know, clean, playful, elegant, 90s brutalist style, minimalist. And I'm gonna focus on this one, this 90s brutalist style landing page card that I put together. Really, really simple. Let me open it up. Yeah, and so what we're gonna do is use this Editor X Figma plugin that I just found out about today. Well, you're watching this video, so I probably found out about it in the past. Apparently, I can just install the Editor X plugin, say convert this to Editor X, and that's it. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. I'm not convinced it's going to work. Okay, so there's a few steps here. I imagine that the worse your design is in terms of organization, the worse it's going to convert into Editor X, because it's probably looking for, you know, your frame, your containers and groups, your naming. There's a phrase that I like it in the audio engineering world. I like music. I like recording music. And one of the phrases that I heard probably in like an audio recording for dummies book is crap in, crap out, which essentially means if you put garbage into the machine, like your input, your recording, your sound, your quality, you know, your singing, your initial input recording, if that's bad, no amount of auto-tune and color and EQ and compression and normalization will rescue it. Crap in, crap out. Give it a good, clean, quality signal in, then we can do some real cool stuff here, okay? I've gone ahead and made sure that I've organized this as best as possible. I by no means am a Figma expert. So it's possible that you might be a Figma designer and go, man, Brad, why did you do it like this? If that's the case, hit me up in the comments and tell me how I can stop sucking at Figma so that my designs can transfer better into Editor X. Got it? Thank you. Okay, so here's what we need to do now. So I got my Figma file. I need to go to the community tab in Figma. You can do that online or you can do it in the app. And in community, figma.com/community, you can actually just search Editor X and it's gonna show up plugins. There's one plugin called Editor X or Figma 2X. I've already installed it. Do that, install it, and then open your Figma. You probably need to restart it. Now what you do is you select the frame that you want to convert to Editor X. So I'm gonna select this main frame with like the background itself. This is what I wanna convert to Editor X. And apparently if you select multiple frames, it creates separate pages. I haven't quite figured all of it out yet. I'm just doing this right now. So style 90s, plugins, Editor X. Little modal window pop up here. Turn your designs into a website. Seamlessly export your Figma frames into Editor X. Let's get started. So what do we got? We got one frame selected. What does it say? Gives us some tips, very, very cool. Site styles, we got 7 typography styles. Pulled straight from the design itself, okay? Color styles. That looks pretty good to me. And media, so it's taking the images. And I'm gonna, and no shapes. So if I had drawings and vectors, then it would take the shapes. Export to Editor X. So it says copy and paste the entire URL of this project below. Okay, so then I gotta go to the web version of Figma, find this project, copy that URL. Very easy. So I'm gonna go to mine. I'm gonna go to the one page site. I got my style 90s. I'm gonna select that URL. I'm gonna paste it in here, export. All right, so now it says start turning your designs into an Editor X website, checking your file. And this is a bit of a, it seems like a conversion process. So let's see what it tells us to do and what's next. Okay, right. Your design's assets, including media styles and more, will be uploaded to Editor X so you can build your dream website. There it is right there, a little preview. So I'm gonna click create site. Leave this tab open, this may take a few minutes. Feel free to grab a coffee. Oh, looks like we had an error. Technical error. Okay, bugs, remember? I told you all about the bugs. Sometimes this happens, let's just try again. All right, welcome to your Editor X site. Get to know the workspace and tools. Figma designs, you converted. Okay, let's check it out, start the tour. Add your assets and more. Find all your images, shapes from Figma here. Add other elements to complete your site. So under the media, my uploads, everything is uploaded here right from Figma, okay. I'll probably wanna rename the files, do some SEO, but so far so good. All right, manage elements and layers, collapse and expand layers to view all your elements, see how they're nested to understand your site's hierarchy, okay? View all your pages, each of your Figma frames were turned into a site page. Add a menu element so that visitors can navigate between them. Okay, so if I added multiple frames on the top level, it would have converted it to main pages, and then I would just need to add a menu and link them. We got our typography styles, fonts that I uploaded to use on the site are saved here. Changing the site styles will update designs across the site. Cool, all right. That's pretty cool. Adjust color styles, so this is the color palette it pulled in. It really didn't pull in too much here. It's all black and white and gray, except for this pink, so I mean, that's easy to fix. Design for breakpoints, and then this is, you know, you can adjust it for breakpoints and do some responsive design here, that makes sense. And then layout and design elements, set an element's properties from the inspector. Okay, we get this, we know how this works. This is where now we have an Editor X site that came from Figma. There's probably some stuff that we need to modify and change. So let's just check it out and see what the damage is. All right, so honestly, I'm looking at this and I'm going, that's pretty good. Obviously not exactly the same. We're missing our background. Looks like some type issues, but you know what? Not bad. Let's check out our layers. So we got the page right here. We got the section, which is the whole thing. Then a container with multiple containers nested. Yeah, okay. It's in the same layer too. So it's in the same order. So that bottom container is at the top like it was in Figma. So if I go to my Figma and I go to this container, each of these sections are containers in Editor X. Section bio, which is the top layer, it's at the bottom. This is section bio, it's at the bottom. So that's really cool how that converts. All right, so let's just make a few changes. So I'm gonna select the full section. And I'm gonna go to design. I'm gonna select color. And surprise, new feature alert in Editor X, gradients. We can do gradients in Editor X now. Thank you, I love it. Select that, let's make our gradient. So we're gonna choose like that purple, no, that pink. What do we got here? Yeah, it's like that pink, and then we got like a blue. Let's grab that blue from Figma. All right, let's add it in here. Go to our color styles actually. There we go. So now we can go back to our gradient. Color, pick our gradient. We're going here. We're going pink. And then blue. Yeah. And then we're gonna change that direction. Sweet, looks good. Okay, just gonna rip through here, change some of the typography. Obviously there's a couple issues here. Fix that. All right, so the image, select the image. I'm actually going to have the background color be white. and the image opacity down, kind of like in the design, perfect. And this button, it needs that background outline. So we're gonna go shadows, customize the shadow. There we go, fix the text. All right, this is looking pretty good. And we're gonna do the same. I'm actually gonna save this little section as an asset to a library. And I'm just gonna delete this little part. And I'm actually going to add an asset from our library I just added. Just gonna pop it in here. Use the same style. All right, and then one more section here. I'm gonna select these three things, stack them. There it is. Oh, wow. Is it going to replace Editor X web designers anytime soon? No, absolutely not. It's simply a tool that helps you speed up the process for something that's generally pretty repetitive. When you start up an Editor X site from a design, especially if you're designing from Figma, you gotta get the colors, you gotta get the type, you gotta get all the assets and the images. So the fact that we can use software, a little plugin to convert it all over for us, that's really, really cool. But that's just what I think. What do you think? Let me know down in the comments. And then watch this video right here. See you in the next one.